It's the common thread for many fatal crashes in West Texas, and medical experts say it's becoming far too common. You heard right. Since last Thursday, a total of 9 people have died in crashes here in the basin. CBS 7's Tatum Gwynn followed the path many of these crash victims take from the road to the emergency room. She just discovered what leads the deaths along the way. She joins us now live with our top story tonight. Tatum?
Jay, I learned today that none of the passengers that were in this van were wearing a seatbelt at the time of the crash. All right, now these vehicles are at the DPS office here in Odessa. Now, usually when a vehicle is involved in a crash, a wrecker service comes and picks it up and takes it to the yard. However, this crash was so bad that the DPS troopers transported it here to their yard to further the investigation. I spoke with hospital officials today who say that crashes like this one are a story they are all too familiar with. Distracting himself from the tragic reality, a man picks up what's left behind from a wreck that killed 3. 9 men were on their way to work when the driver attempted to turn left, but they turned too soon. A white truck hit the rear passenger side of the van, sending them flying across the road. It's a common thread emergency room doctors are seeing in fatal crashes on our roads in the past year.
What we're seeing is a lot of patients aren't restrained. They are coming in from motor vehicle accidents. They're not restrained. They're being ejected, and they have more serious injuries.
In fact, the emergency department at Medical Center Hospital has seen a 30% increase in trauma patients in the past year from crashes.
They are very worried. They're worried that with all of the training we have, with all of the equipment, and the reality of it is with everything we have, we're still losing patients.
They say since a lot of these crashes involve heavy vehicles, the injuries they're seeing are more severe.
Larger trucks that are out on the streets, the actual damage to those vehicles, and you can tell that your patients are injured more because of the mechanisms that they're being injured by.
Earp says the doctors in the department are urging people to slow down and buckle up because you never know what lies ahead. I'm told that the 4 other passengers that were transported to the hospital from this van still remain there. No word on their condition at this time, but I have done some digging on this van. Now, I found out that this van belongs to a company called Sanhill. They do have a local office here. However, the license plate on this particular van says that they are from Montana. I did find the local number for their office here, and it would not go through. It was like it was disconnected. I will, of course, keep you updated on the investigation of this crash, and as we learn more, we will be sure to update you on our website, cbs7.com. For now, reporting live in Odessa, I'm Tatum Gwynn, CBS 7 News.